Hey, MzeroA Nation, Jason here. Remember those really tough questions on the private pilot knowledge test? Where are you in relation to the station? Then they give you the three OBS indications, and you're just trying to figure out, am I northwest, the VOR, it's a to, it's a from, where is it? And what is the real world applicability of all of that? Well, in today's video, which is a clip taken from our actual private pilot online ground school, I'm going to help you get a better understanding and real-world applicability as to VOR navigation. Now, this clip, it's a little bit shorter than the one that's actually in the online ground school. You're going to be able to see about half of it here. But if you want to see more, in fact, if you want to see the entire online ground school, I'm also offering up a 2-week no strings attached trial as well. Links are in the description below this video. But let's go ahead and let's cut to that clip and learn a little bit more about VOR navigation. Hey guys, welcome into the VOR module. So we're starting in the flight simulator. And I like starting the sim because it allows me to take you guys outside of the aircraft. So we've got our VOR already properly tuned up to the right frequency and we're flying, but I was just dropped on a map. I have no clue where I'm at. So let's go ahead. Let's start that airplane flying here for a second. The first question you always ask yourself when trying to figure out how to navigate to a VOR is you need to answer this question. Where am I in relation to the station? Well, I'm all tuned up, so how can I tune up my OBS right over here on a 2 indication? See this flag here? Show me on a 2 indication. I want to tune up and center up on that. So let's do that really quick here. And I'm going to twist to the right. How do I know I need to move to the right? Well, because my needle is over to the right. So let's do that. See, I'm twisting there. My headings are coming up. Here it comes. It's swinging in. It's swinging in. It's swinging in. I'm right up top here. And look at that. I'm like a 045. Let me pause for a second right here to make a point. If I wanted to proceed directly to the station now, I would head 045. Let's unpause it now and let's actually go ahead and do that. So watch this. Now I'm going to come down and I'm going to move the old heading bug and let's proceed like a 045-ish type heading and let's see what that does for me. All right, we'll roll out and now I'm on that heading that my OBS says I'm heading to the station. Let's pause it now for a second and let's step outside of the airplane and take a look at that. Let's go to our local map and take a look at what we just did. Here we are out here. Here's the Ocala VOR. You can see I turned to that 045 heading. We continue that going. We're gonna head straight on in to the actual VOR. As you can see, we were kind of a little bit to the right of that, heading out this way. We turned out to the left. Now we're heading out to the VOR. Let's do that same thing again, except let's move the airplane. Let's put me on, I'm gonna drop myself out here this time. All right. Let's go ahead, everything looks set, and let's do the same thing again. Give that a second to load here, and we're gonna reset it and say, okay, where am I now in relation to the station? Same thing, VOR's already tuned up. I'm on that previous heading though, but where am I in relation to that station? So here I am on a 2 indication. Let's go ahead and center that back up now. So I'm twisting to the left. Why am I twisting to the left? Well, because my needle's to my left. So I'm gonna twist and twist here, getting that coming around. The sim doesn't move quite as fast. I know I gotta be getting close. Oh, here it comes. And there we are, centered on like a 310. Let's go ahead and let's now turn to a heading of about 310. Not about, let's do it. So I'm gonna move, I'm using the autopilot here to make it real easy so I can talk and fly all at the same time here. I'm gonna twist that heading bug around to a 310 heading here. Let that come around. You'll be able to see that turn. And let's let this turn kind of continue to happen here for half a second. Autopilot's going to start rolling out. Now, something really interesting happened. I rolled out on a 310, but look at my needle now. It's off to the left still. That's because I took so long to make that turn. I'm continuing to fly through radial. So geez, let's go ahead. If I want to get back on course, I need to turn more to the left. And let's do this. There's two things you could do. You could cheat and just move your OBS up top. Oh, look, I'm back on my course. And then adjust your heading to that new heading of 305. But let's not do that. Let's go ahead and let's leave it on that 310 and say, how am I going to get back on that? Well, I need to adjust my heading more to the left to intercept that radial. This is the beginnings of intercepting and tracking. I need to go left of the course, so let's do that. 310 is the goal, so I'm going to go a little bit to the left and try to reel that needle back on in. And what I want you to do is watch this needle here. Watch this needle start to slowly sneak its way back in. And once it gets close to center, or what I call the top of the donut, if you can see it right here, there's this little circle right here. We call that the top of the donut. Once it gets there, I'm going to turn back to that 310. See the needle slowly sneaking its way in? I'm getting my heading ready to move back to that 310 heading. Here it comes. And I need to anticipate it. So let's start that and let's move back to that 310 now. And we roll out and we're just about back on center. If I wanted to get really picky, I could inch a little bit more to the left. Let's pause it now and go back to our map and show what just happened here for a second. Back to our local map. All right, well, here we are. And you can see our track here. Look at where we started. We were flying. We had to tune up. We had to find where we are in relation to the station, and we began to make that turn. See how that turn took us towards our VOR? And you can see how we kind of started to get off that course a little bit, and here's where we put in that intercept to get back on that course, back on, and this is showing you kind of that course line going through that VOR that we were working to kind of reel back in.
So there you have it, a little introduction, we'll call it, into VOR navigation. If you want to see that clip in its entirety, and about 200 other fantastic private pilot videos inside of our private pilot online ground school, there's a link below this video for a 2-week, no strings attached free trial of our online ground school. I hope you will check that out to get a better understanding. Listen, MzeroA.com and our online ground school isn't just a great way to pass your knowledge test, to pass your check ride. We are truly a flight training community that's going to teach you to be that safe real-world pilot and teach well beyond the test as well. Hope you'll take us up on that 2-week trial as well and keep me posted on your success as you pursue your certificates and ratings. Have a fantastic day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya. I sincerely hope you loved watching this video. These videos you see online are simply just the tip of the iceberg of what we do here at MzeroA.com. MzeroA is a complete private, instrument, commercial, and FOI online ground school. Everything is done at your own pace online. You watch our lessons, also online, take practice exams, all from any device. If you love these free videos we put out here on YouTube and Facebook, I encourage you to check out our complete online ground school for the knowledge test, check ride, and most importantly, setting you up to make you that safe real-world pilot. Take a 2-week free trial, no strings attached, of our online ground school by visiting mzeroa.com/trial.